Hey, Manpreet, Daphne here. How are you? Hope all's well with you. And you're getting on well. I can't remember when your exam is. I know you told me, and I'm sorry, I can't remember. But this is seriously good. Great letter. Manpreet, I can't find a task two. Did you mean to attach a task two as well? Normally, you send me task two and two task one together. That's easier for both of us. I'm going to correct this one, but if you have a task two to do, send it to me as soon as you can. Okay. So, letter. Haha. Again. Yes. Spare room in your apartment you'd like to rent out. Well done. You're writing to the student accommodation office, not to the student. So, you've got that perfectly. Dear sir, yours faithfully. Excellent. Comma just at the end after yours faithfully. So, dear sir, I'm writing this letter to you in response to your advert on the college's bulletin board regarding student accommodation. Your name, yep, that's lovely. This place is, so I would say my home is, rather than this place, my home is a two-bedroom accommodation, and the room would be available from 1st January onwards, as my roommate will be leaving. This is definitely going to happen, so you can use the future there. We'll be leaving by the end of December. Lovely. And would is perfect. Great grammar. The biggest advantage of this location is its accessibility co to college and walking distance to Fairview Mall, where all the grocery stores are located. Besides this, the bus stops just across the building. Okay, just opposite from, I would say, either across the street from the building or opposite the building. Okay, better maybe across the street from our building. Yeah, something like that, I would possibly, if you really want to just show amazing prepositions. Good. The conditions for the student would be to submit the first and last month's deposit of $500, including utilities. Yep. The person should be clean. Be careful, because if you say to me clean, that literally means clean, like you've had a shower this morning. So I think that's a bit strange. I would probably say clean living, which is okay, and a non-smoker. Just so you know how we like saying things twice. So clean living means, yeah, you want them to keep the whole place tidy. Or actually, you could say, it's a good word, tidy, just the opposite to messy. Tidy and a non-smoker. I think I like that best. Tidy and a non-smoker. Or maybe all of those. Let's go all of them. Because then you're really explaining what you mean. I'm willing to say at least 6 months and give me, I wouldn't repeat at least. Give me 1 month's, you need an apostrophe S there, notice before leaving. I'd be very thankful if you, I would say grateful rather than thankful normally, if you could advertise this in the relevant places. Because presumably they're going to get your information and then advertise it out to the students. So I'd be very thankful if you could, or I think I'd prefer grateful if you could. Okay, really, really nice letter, Manpreet. Excellent. Top, top, top stuff. Fantastic. Okay, hope to hear from you soon. Thanks.